beautiful day for
the Loras College Duhawks
face the visiting Central College Dutch in an ARC conference showdown.
I am joined here in the booth with David Peters. What are you looking for from this Duhawks offense and defense today?
Well, to me, it comes down to three things. First off, they're going up against a great offense. Try to limit the amount of possessions they can get by controlling the clock. Create turnovers while capitalizing off of them. They haven't been great doing that these past few weeks. Then finally, pressuring the quarterback, forced him to make his wrong reads.
Yeah, we are moments away from kickoff here. For our starters on offense,
should they start? We got Evan England in at quarterback number 12. Starting running back for the Duhawks, number 2, Johnny Kaysen. Starting tight end, number 84, Owen Libby. Wide receiver, we've got number 13, Jaheim Haynes, and number 81, Michael Crawford starting out. Left tackle, number 54, Tyson Smith. Left guard, number 78, Caden Griffiths. At center, number 62, Cotter Durden. Right guard, number 65, Justin Hayes. And at right tackle, number 72, Caden Carnes. So what are we looking at on defense? Who do we got going out there?
We have Sean Doyle at defensive end, Elijah Dirt and nose, Jonah Clark on the other side. And at linebacker, Brandon Phelps, Dawson Charlie, Andrew Hafel, and Michael Mixon. Cornerback, we have Zacchaeus Knighton and Michael Barber. And we have at safety, Cormac Flynn and Owen Kelly.
Yeah, we'll see certainly how this defense does. They've got the coin toss right now.
What's your call?
Tails.
Dutch with tails.
It's tails.
Tails with the toss.
See the call. It looks.
Defender choice in the second half.
All right, so the Loras offense will be indeed starting first with the Dutch deferring. Of course, after half, they will receive from the Duhawks. So something very important, you know, strong showings right out of the gate for the Duhawks. Very key this season. They're a 2-2 team in this ARC. And again, this is going to be one heck of a showdown.
Oh, absolutely.
It is homecoming 2023 for the Duhawks. Very full Rock Bowl. Just looking right outside our booth, tons of alums and present Duhawks alike. This morning, tailgate, great to see a lot of people showing up to that. Obviously enjoying some good food and, homecoming stuff.
Want to add on, Loras is 2-0 in their last two homecoming games.
That's exactly right, right? So something's got to give here. You know, hopefully we're looking at a 3-0 start for the Duhawks, but the Dutch, they got other plans today. They've got a full stands over there too. Their fans traveling very good.
Yeah, last year Loras beat Central 38-35. Central was ranked number 12 in the country at that point.
Yeah, again, and it was almost 2-3 years ago today. 53-19 win for Central. Of course, that was at Central College. You know, they were number 10 at the time. So here we go, moments away from kickoff. And our returner for the Duhawks, number 11, Harrison Willis out there. And here we go. Football underway here at the Rock Bowl. Here's the kick and the return. Going pretty far, we've got at least 10 yards. Up to, it looks like, the 25-yard line, and the offense is coming in. There's the offense. Talking over just initial plays.
That's what the tone early today.
You got it, especially, you know, close games. You know, it means all the difference, right?
Mm-hmm.
There we get a look. There's QB Evan England, Jr., out of Wheaton, Illinois. Takes a snap. England looking to throw. Got a receiver there. And that's Johnny Kaysen, the running back.
Good blocking from the O-line right there, too.
Evan England's pass is complete to number 2, Johnny Kaysen.
Johnny Kaysen, also a junior. 5'8", 170, running back out of Lutz, Florida. He's going to be motioned back. There's the snap. England's going to look. He's going to run. And England tackled down, gets a few yards there.
In about one. Quick pressure off the edge right there, too.
Yeah, the Dutch trying to do their best defense, try to limit what Evan can do on offense here.
Yeah, he can run the ball, too. He's, you know, not quite dual threat, but he's an athlete.
Certainly so. Just reading the plays. And here we go. There's Johnny Kaysen. Johnny's going to run and tackled. Looks like a few yards short of the marker for sure.
And those swarm of defenders right there.
Yeah. Fourth down. I can't imagine they're going to go for it here. Not this early.
Not this early. Not this part of the field. Yeah, fourth and three.
Yeah. Got a 40. Number 41, Jarrett Kinney, sophomore out of Roscoe, Illinois. A high snap. Can he get it off? He does. It's going to bounce over just short of the 30-yard line. Dutch are just going to let it roll.
Oh, the punter did get hit. It will be a first down, most likely, if it's on the defense.
Yeah, flag. It looks like that's going to be roughing the kicker there.
That's 15 yards, if so.
And it'll be a meeting of the minds here at the 50-yard line. We'll see what the head referee says here. You know, officials today, Stephen Schaub, Elias Randall, Chris Michael.
Well, so they call it running into the kicker. Still first down, but not as much yardage.
Yeah, that's a huge call early on.
Good break for the Duhawks.
Yeah, get the offense back out there. You know, we hear the caws of the Duhawk over here. So here we go, first and 10, new set of downs here for the Duhawks. Looks like it'll be close to the 37, 38-yard line. Case in the backfield. Evan, handoff to Case, and Case's going to get some good yardage there. About 5 or 6 yards down. And it'll be second and five, second and six.
Duhawks have been running a tempo offense all year. It's been working pretty well for them, averaging about 30 points a game.
Yeah, you know, I expect there to be fresh guys out there for sure after the bye week last week and coming off of that loss against UD. Evan running back. He's got a receiver down potentially. He throws it out.
Monty Brown was, you know, target.
He was the week three ARC player of the week, wasn't he?
Yes, he was.
There's going to be third down here for the Duhawks. I would expect at some point, you know, Owen Libby, the tight end, 84, just at the center part of your screen there. He's got to get some action here.
Most definitely.
Here's Evan. O-line giving up a little bit. Evan's got to throw out pressure. And fourth down. Back-to-back plays. You know, the O-line trying to do their best, but defensive line for
very
Central
good
Dutch.
Line.
Unbelievable good. Right there.
Quick pressure once again.
So here we go. Number 41, Jarrett Kinney out here to punt again. He's got a boot. Can he get it off? He will. And the return there.
Fair caught.
I'll mark it about the 27-yard line. Now let's take a look at this offense for the Central Dutch. Who do we got out here?
At quarterback, we have Hunter Hoffman. He's a sophomore. Running back is Jordan Rush, the senior. Tight end, Nick Coble, another senior. Wide receivers, Logan Mont and Jeff Herbers, both are seniors. Ryan New is another senior. Then offensive line, Tyler Harms at left tackle. Left guard is Tristan Hunt. Center, Maximus Ritano. Right guard, Levy Jansen. And then right tackle, Cade Tippett.
And that play just tipped off the fingers. Looks that was number 13, Ryan New.
New is the Dutch leading receiver coming to this game.
You know, this is an offense, right? They've been scoring 179 points overall this year, but per game it's about 35, 39 points per game. So high-scoring offense for sure. As you got to look there, nice run for Jordan Rush. 5'8", 175. Yeah, he's no small guy. Hard to take down. Looks like we'll get some subs early here.
The Dutch are 3-0 on the road coming into this game as well, while the Dewhawks are 2-0 at home.
So here we go. Third down. Dewhawk defense doing their best. Try and limit what the Dutch can do here. Hoffman will take the snap. Hoffman running out. He's going to go to the side. Can he make a play here? He cannot as he throws out.
So before, pressuring the quarterback is a massive key to winning this game for Loras.
It looked like Sean Doyle got him down there trying to force some pressure down. And of course he does. It's fourth down. We'll have to have the punt team down there.
Quick three and out for the Dewhawk defense.
No, you'd like to see that for sure. We've got Ian Brocious, number 16, out of Stockton, Illinois, out to return the punt. And here's the snap and the kick. Pretty decent kick, Brocious. Got a fair catch there. Looks like about the 35-yard line. So both offenses stalling a little bit here. No way to tell now, but definitely looks like it'll be a defensive battle. It's a cooler day here, you know, the past few days in Dubuque. Definitely got a lot cooler, so that's got to be a little bit of a factor here.
Yeah, pretty warm first half of the week.
So here we go, Dewhawk offense back out. Let's see if they can come down the field, march down. Let's get this homecoming crowd going. And here's the snap. He's going to throw it over. That's Jamel Britt, number 44, on the backfield. Pass. He's going to run out. What a great pass.
Yeah, nice swing pass to the running back.
England's pass is complete. Again, Jamel Britt, the leading rusher here on this team, despite not starting. He's going to motion right. It'll be second down for the Dewhawks. England's going to go left really early. He's going to run out, try and get some yardage.
Design QB run.
And Evan's been more of a scrambler. You know, the offensive line doing their best, of course, but he's been a scrambler a lot this year, especially at home. The close game against Benedictine University is a 42-41 win. He was scrambling a lot but making some great plays at the same time.
Yeah, you know, you want those kind of quarterbacks who can, you know, make something out of broken plays. Especially their legs, they need to do.
Here we go on third down for the Dewhawk offense. England's going to throw out. Got a guy down. And that should be a first down right there. That's wide receiver number 81, Michael Crawford.
His first catch of the day.
Is there anybody on this offense that you're screaming looking like, hey, you know, he could be this X factor today?
Monty Brown. He is the best player on this offense. You know, he's full of talent, but he makes plays when needed. And he's a Dewhawks leading receiver as well this year.
So it will be a third down. There's a flag on the play. And the Dewhawks, a little extra yards down.
Yeah, third and 14 now. Wipes away that first down catch.
Taking some time to make sure everybody's set, ready to go. We sure are. Let's see, third and 14, Evan England. There's a snap in the throw. He's going to look. He's got to run. He's got to run to the right side of the field. He's going to throw. He's got, oh, nice tackle down. Looks like about the 43, 42-yard line. That was Ian Brocious. They will be short. At the 42, it'll be a fourth down and... Again, special teams got to come out, try and boot it down the field.
Yeah, penalties like that can stall drives. You saw it right there.
Kenny's going to kick it. It's a pretty far kick. Here we go on the return, about 10, 15 yards. That is punt returner Hunter Wilkinson for the Central Dutch, number 19. And we'll see another look at this this Duhok defense yet again.
Jerry Keeney with the punt for Morris. Tackle was made by Ian Brocious.
Now, looking at this defense, you know, is there anybody that you're looking at and saying, hey, this player needs to step up or this player will be a big-time playmaker, try and get some stops?
Mike Barber, number 4 on defense. He's been great to start the year.
Here's the play.
Makes a tackle right there.
Yeah, this offense. 131 first downs and opposing offenses 98. So we'll see here, second down. And it'll be a third down. Big play on defense. That looks like Andrew Hafel. He's hyped up. The fans here are hyped up. First big play of the game.
Front seven's getting a lot of pressure early. Something you want to see.
Dutch offense looking for some answers here early. It's about 9 minutes left in this first quarter. And here we go on third down for the Dutch. Snap, Hoffman's gonna look, he's gonna look left. He's got a man wide. And here's the throw and the catch here by wide receiver Jeff Herbers. That's a first down.
Offensive line game, great protection that play. Hurrying up to the line of scrimmage right here.
Yeah, hurry up offense here. We see it a lot in the NFL and Division One. Central. Hoffman's going to get guy out there. There we go, second down. Looks like that was a gain of 2 yards. Logan Mott, the 5'8", 180 senior. Yeah, the average yards per attempt for this offense is about 6. See if they can get some yards here. Hoffman's going to look. He's going to toss it.
Thrown and
looks like that's number 4. Tight end, Nick Coble. He's lucky to get that off. I mean, the defensive line right there.
Barreling down. Loris defense and a lot of stops in the early downs.
Hoffman's going to make sure his guys are ready. And here we go. Third down. Can they convert? Will the Duhawks stop him here? Hoffman's going to throw. He's got curbs just off his hands. Nick Coble, excuse me with that. Looks like that's a fourth down.
So they're going for it.
Guts early here.
What you call four down territory. Just outside their red zone.
Duhawk defense. This crowd you can hear. Getting loud here at the Rock Bowl. They're rocking here. Hoffman is going to throw it out to Coble. Coble misses. And a big stop on defense for this Loris defense.
Turnover on downs. Duhawks take possession of the ball at their own 25.
It's a big stop here, especially early on in the first quarter, trying to build some momentum.
No team has been able to get any of that so far.
We'll get another look at Evan England, Monty Brown.
Their third time on the field.
Yeah. There is number 5 on your screen. He's marching up there into position. You know, this Loris offense, 34 points per game. So when we're looking at about 36, 37, 38 for the Dutch, 34 for the Duhawks, it's going to be a really close game. England's going to toss that out, and it'll be quick second down.
Yeah, Jaheim Haynes was the target that time.
Yeah, Monty Brown, leading receiver, 84, basically 85 yards per game. Can we see him here?
You would think so.
It'll be a handoff to Kaysen, and he'll be stopped. It'll be a loss of yards there. It'll be third and long.
Interior D-line of the Dutch. Very, very good.
Third and 10. Again, 1-1 are the Duhawks in conference play. They lost to Luther earlier this season and against University of Dubuque in the Key City Clash just 2 weeks ago. They're looking to rebound here. There have been some moments, you know, you could look, you know, maybe they're going to march down the field and get something. They certainly got to convert here if they want to do that, try and score early. And here we go. Third and long for this Duhawk offense. England's going to look. He's going to scramble out. Maybe he's got someone he's going to toss out. He got some yards there. We got a flag on the play. And that was to 81, Michael Crawford.
Might see an illegal forward pass. He might have been in front of the line of scrimmage in that throw.
We'll see what the boys in black and white say down there. Again, they've got a better vantage point than we do from up here, but your call certainly could be it here.
Yep. Offensive
yep.
5-yard penalty from the spot of the foul. Loss of down. Fourth down.
That loss of down is huge.
Yeah, makes it fourth and...
Fourth and long for sure.
Yeah. Fourth and 10.
And here we go. Jarrett Kinney, number 41. Let's see if he can make some magic here. A little disappointing to see from the Duhawks, you know, early on. Again, there's plenty of time for them to make this up. Of course, they got to rely on the defense here, make some big stops as they did last time.
So we're capitalizing off of those turnovers, regardless of their, you know, takeaways or turnover on downs. Matters.
Here's Kenny. Decent bounce about the 45, 46 yard line. The Duhawks trying to stop it before the ball could go a little farther.
Both defenses making massive plays so far to start the game.
That's where essentially they'll have it.
Yeah, very defensive game.
It's exactly what Loris wanted, too. Keep the game close.
We'll get another look. Hoffman and the Dutch.
Yeah, this Loris defense has allowed 40.5 points per game so far. And they're not looking like that so far to start this game.
Without a doubt. Here we go. First and 10 here. He's got a guy out. And some yards there. Add that to his tab. That is wide receiver number 5, Jeff Herbers. Great catch as well. Again, hurry up offense. We're going to see that. Looks like a lot for the Central Dutch. Hoffman going to pass it off there.
Get swallowed up.
Number 21, Jordan Rush. Get some yards there. You know, when we see hurry up offense like that and then they go immediately to a rushing play, it's typically trying to catch off guard the defense. Looks like Duhawk defense was ready for that there. We got second down.
Run everybody up the line on this play.
Here we go. Hoffman looking. He's got a man out there. There he is. Can he catch it? And there's a flag.
Pat, defensive PI.
Wow. Saw it put up hands up early. Unless they saw something else, but it looks like that'll be pass interference.
Ball's just gonna underthrown.
And that was Rashad Johnson.
Catching that play in general.
Yeah, Rashad Johnson. Oh, that'll hurt.
Tough break the Loris defense.
We've seen some flags early here for the Duhawks. Both sides of the ball.
First time a team's been in the red zone today.
Yeah. No, can the Dutch, can they score here? We'll see what Hoffman and the Dutch will do. First down, fresh set of downs for them. And a nice run there for Jordan Rush. You know, rushing yards, they average about 59 per game. They're doing pretty well there. It looks like they'll probably break that.
Quarterback Hunter Hoffman is their leading rusher.
Here we go. Jordan Rush again.
Short of the first down.
It'll be short of the marker. Third down. Third and short. You got to figure at least a field goal here if you're the Dutch.
Give us the Jordan Rush once again.
Anything less than that is disappointment. Third and two.
But again, third and two on the 10-yard line. Just about five seconds to go in this first quarter.
5 minutes.
Hoffman's going to get the snap. He's going to throw. He's got a receiver. And it's a touchdown for the Dutch.
Pass caught by Jeff Gerber. Touchdown for Central.
Yeah, again, Jeff Herbers in the end zone.
Made massive plays early on today.
No, some great plays for the Dutch. They'll set up for the field goal kick. Excuse me, the extra point. And that's through the uprights.
Extra point by Logan Sundblad is good.
It's a great start for the Central Dutch. And here we go. We got live replay here. And Hoffman finding Herbers
right over his head.
Right over his head. You know, as a receiver, keeping your hands up over, you know, most of the time, if you bring it in, results in a touchdown.
DB has their hands up right in that play, too. When you're looking at the ball, try to swat it away.
Again, that's decent coverage there by the DB, but, you know, if you see the ball soaring up ahead of you, you got to think you try and swat it down, but we'll have to wait to see for those adjustments on defense. Central will kick off here. So 7-0 here, the first quarter, about 4 minutes and 53 seconds left. If you're the Dutch, this is great for you. Let's try and spoil the homecoming fun for the Duhawks. And here's the boot here.
That was Jeff Herber's fifth touchdown of the season.
And here's the return. Turn just short of the 20-yard line. Got a great kick there, too.
Returned by Ian Brocious.
Yeah, Ian Brocious running there.
First down for Lewis.
Yeah, first and 10 from the 19-yard line. And this offense, try and get down there. Have 4 minutes to do it. So Jamel Britt out there is the main running back.
A lot of pistol and shotgun early for this Horus offense.
He's going to motion. England's going to get the quick throw off. Good enough for at least a few yards.
Screen pass to Michael Crawford.
We'll see a lot of Michael Crawford today.
Stop at the 22.
Again, this is an offense where they're passing, on average, 54 yards per game. Be a quick second down. Here's the snap. England gonna hand it off to Jamel Britt. He's gonna get in there. Can't stop that man. He's gonna be short of the marker. It'll be a third and short.
Hurry up here.
JB to the left, as he is nicknamed. He's gonna get the handoff again, and there's a first down. Shades of Derrick Henry right there.
Another carry here, Jamel Britt to the 32.
Something you see a lot in these Mike Leach air raid offenses is a quarterback's quiet counting, you know, the clap, the signal, the snap.
Fresh set of downs here for the Duhawks. See if they can march down even further. England's going to get the snap. He's going to hand off, potentially. Nope. He's got a guy. There's Damani Brown. He's going to keep going. Can't tackle that man.
Game changer.
Game changer. That's why he was ARC Player of the Week, Week 3. This crowd hyped up here. Cheerleaders getting the crowd going.
Yeah, he has 8 touchdowns on the season.
And you said he's the game changer.
Oh, absolutely.
Let's see. Do we see him here again?
Right back to him.
Certainly we do. There he goes, out of bounds. Stop clock, 3:18. And it's another first down for the Duhawks.
Loud crowd here at the Rock Bowl.
Coming alive here. Here's England. England's got a guy down. And a dropped pass. Number 83.
Yeah, this is a Duhawk offense that, you know, averages 276.5 passing yards per game.
Central Dutch have some defensive substitutions, offensive substitutions as well. We see Owen Libby coming out there at tight end. And you said it, Damani Brown, your X factor on this Loris offense.
He's a Loris outside receiver on this play.
And the handoff here to Jamel Britt. He's going to get some yards
nice
out.
Tackle.
It's a nice tackle. It looks like everybody getting in on the fun there.
Third and medium coming up here.
Yeah, that's a great play, too. Just try and get some yards.
Great vision from the running back, too, by cutting it right back outside.
See Michael Crawford out wide. Third and four. You got Crawford and Monty Brown out on the right.
And a doubles look.
Evan England, hand off to Jamel Britt. Is he going to get there to the marker? It looks like he's a bit
short. About a yard short.
We'll see where they mark him.
If you're the Loris offense, you're driving down this field, you go for it right here. Try to match that touchdown. Fourth and one.
Yeah, fourth and one.
And they keep the offense out there.
Yeah, we'll see Jaheim Haynes on the left side. There's JB trying to hype out the crowd. Getting loud here. The Rock Bowl is rocking. Trying to make some noise in support of this offense. They need it. Let's see what the Duhawks do. Here's Evan England. He's got JB, and it's swatted down by the Central defense.
A turnover on downs for this Duhawk offense.
Again, number 17, Brody Klein. And turnover on downs. You mentioned it earlier, David. Whoever capitalizes on these opportunities will likely come ahead.
And you see it all the time. Whoever wins a turnover battle has a great chance to win this game. Score points off those turnovers as well.
Looks like that'll be about the 24, 23-yard line. A minute 38 here to go in the first quarter.
Quick fly in first quarter. Warriors in a 3-4 look.
And here's Hoffman and the Dutch. Hoffman, he's got a man out. He's going to air it out, and it's just out of the hands. The receiver down there. Certainly close. Hoffman's done that a couple of times here in this first quarter. Again, that's the tight end, 24, Jacob Birch. Nice throw play as well, just a little overthrow. Here's Hoffman. He's got a man out to the side, and the tackle.
Up early.
Here comes the boom.
Mike Barber comes in flying.
6'3 junior out of Zephyrus Hills.
Another guy said the music made a massive impact in today's game. Two tackles so far for him.
Great defensive showing here thus far on this drive.
Press coverage from this Loris defense.
Third and long. Hoffman, he's going to throw it out.
Incomplete.
Oh! Incomplete to number five, Jeff Herbers. And special teams will come out for both sides.
Another three and out forced by the Duhawks today. That's the third one.
Two words to describe this game thus far, defensive battle.
Entertaining one at that, too. Both punting units run a shield punt formation.
And here's the punt. Monty Brown's going to receive it. He'll fair catch it at about the 42, 43-yard line. That's where they're going to mark him at the 43. Pretty decent starting field here for this offense, would you say?
Oh, absolutely. Almost on enemy territory. It's got to come back out, force the ball, you know, to your playmakers.
Now, before the game, you and I were talking, you know, momentum's going to be a big, big factor here, especially low-scoring game here in the first quarter. You know, We've got about 48 seconds on the clock. You think potentially a field goal if you're in range, have number 39 Scott Talmadge out there. But for now, England's going to throw to Kaysen. Kaysen's going to get some yardage here and second down.
Laura's been running a lot of swing passes to their running backs today. That's probably the fourth one of this quarter.
No doubt. Again, Jamel Britt not the main back on this play and this drive. Johnny Kaysen back out, number two.
Bunch look for the offense.
Got a receiver motion to
Monty
the left.
Brown.
Here's England. England's going to make the throw, and he's going to be just short of the marker potentially. Looks like that's Jaheim Haynes. Again, Monty Brown being motioned out.
Great blocking by that receiver to set that play up over there.
Here we go, third and short for the Duhawks. Here's England. He's going to pass it off to Kaysen. He holds it. There's Monty Brown.
Last play of the first quarter. The first down for the Duhawks.
And that'll do it for the first quarter as he runs out.
7-0 Central.
Yeah, 7-0. Monty Brown waving his hands up, trying to hype up this crowd. Really close game here. Anybody's game this early on, especially 7-0 game.
Yeah, Monty Brown with 36 receiving yards in the first quarter. Jeff Herbers with 61 and a touchdown.
Yeah, taking a look at these first quarter stats. Four first downs apiece for both teams. Rushing attempts 9-6 for Loris. And rushing yards about even. That's 19 yards for both teams. So very evenly matched on the offensive side of the ball. The rushing yards averaging 3.2 for Central and 2.1 for the Duhawks. So rushing battle, I mean, defense is doing their part, limiting the running backs, trying to get some yardage.
Both teams have a very stout run defense, you know, up the middle.
Without a doubt, for sure. And then receptions, you know, 9-6 in favor of this Loris offense. But again, hasn't amounted to a lot here. We'll see what they can do here as they flip sides.
Yeah, no sacks yet for either defense. Both quarterbacks are relatively clean today.
So here we go, first and 10 for the Duhawks. Receiver motioning wide. England has the ball. He's going to throw it. He's got Damani Brown open.
First down.
Looks like the 17-yard line. Good enough for another first down. Again, they'll take their time here, try and design a play. Monty Brown motions. England's just going to take it, and he's taken down.
Yeah, fake touch pass.
Yeah, that's number 30. That's a linebacker, Reed Packabear. We're going to lose some yardage there, and it'll be second and long here early in the second quarter.
Yeah, doubles look for the receivers, which is two receivers both sides of the line.
Again, running back Jamel Britt in. And here's England. England's going to drop back. He looks. He's got a receiver. There's Monty Brown. Touchdown for the Duhawks.
Monty Brown's ninth touchdown of the season. He is this Duhawks offense.
He's hyped up. We're hyped up. This crowd is rocking here at the Rock Bowl, and they'll go for the PAT.
Tie this game up at 7.
It's 39, Scott Talmadge. Here's the replay. Evan England just airs it out.
Trust his receiver in that play. Good coverage from the DB. Better catch by Monty Brown.
Again, as I mentioned, number 39, Scott Talmadge for the kick, and it's good. 7-7 for the second quarter here. What a drive there for the Duhawks. Yes, you did lose some yardage there, but made it up. Great throw. Dare I say a dot from Evan England to Monty Brown. That connection.
Best word to describe it.
is the fight song playing in the background. So here comes the special teams. We'll get another look at kick returner Jordan Roush. See how far he can take it. As we've seen, Scotty Talmadge, he's got a leg. Hopefully he can carry out. There's a slight breeze coming towards our side of the booth. Definitely plays a little bit of a factor here. And here we go. Here's the kick. A great kick. Take it to about the 8-yard line. And here's the return. And there he goes. Trucks through. He'll take it to about the 41, 42-yard line.
Good blocking from the central kick return team.
Yeah, Hunter Wilkinson. 40. Excuse me, Hunter Wilkinson taking that about 30 yards. This Duhawk defense got to do their part here. Again, momentum. You've got to build on these offensive touchdowns.
Getting stops on defense builds in
there,
too.
Try and get some stops here on defense. Make everybody feel a lot better. And here we go. First down for Hoffman. Here's the snap. He's going to hand it off. And this Duhawk defense, he ain't going nowhere. There's a stop sign right there. That is number 56 here for the Duhawks. And it'll be second and the long for the Dutch.
That was Jonah Clark with the tackle in that play.
What are the Dutch going to do here? The big question we find out now is the receiver motioning right. Here's Hoffman. He's going to take it himself. He could take some yards, but that's not enough to get down to the 10-yard marker, excuse me.
Third down.
Third down for Dutch.
A lot of third down scores by this Forest defense.
Yeah, Sean Doyle making an impact.
Get a stop here. It's back-to-back defensive stops for this defense. Crowd getting loud right now.
About as loud as we've seen the crowd non-touchdown wise.
Yeah.
But here we go. Third and just a little long for Hoffman. Hoffman takes a snap. He's going to look for a receiver. He's going to air it out. He's got one down and defensive stop here. Is there a flag? There is. It looks like that might be pass interference. We'll see what the...
That was an underthrown ball. Tough play to make for the receiver.
Again, that's on Mike Barber.
Another break for this Loras, or sorry, for the Central offense.
Yeah, if you're the defense for the Duhawks, you cannot do that. But there's no time to just wallow on that. You have to keep going, just learn from it. It's like, hey, if I'm Barber, just learn from your mistakes. Just make the better play the next time out. Fresh set of downs for the Dutch. Here's Hoffman. He's going to hand it off and take it himself for a QB run. And he's taken back. Again, all-time record. Central leads 35-8-1 against the Duhawks.
We said earlier, most recent matchup resulted in the Loras win.
But it's homecoming, right?
Yeah.
Got to show up for your fans. Did a great job in responding, but can they keep responding here? Second down for Hoffman. He's going to look to throw. He's got a receiver left. And great play on defense. Looks like that's Rashad Johnson, number 19. He almost had that himself.
Yeah, they're going early to Jeff Herbers.
Yeah, Herbert's getting active.
Getting their playmakers. Field. Both teams getting their playmakers. You know, the ball.
Another here we go.
Third down.
Third down for this Dutch offense. Hoffman drops back. And he is sacked.
Up.
Put up a stop sign right there. That is Brandon Phelpsy. outside linebacker, but they're going to call that.
Wipes out that PI call.
Yeah, that definitely wipes that out.
Back-to-back defensive stops with this D-Hawk off, or defense, my bad.
Special teams out here yet again.
Monty Brown looking to make another play.
If I had a dime for every time special teams are out here for both sides, I might be up to a buck now. But here's the kick. And Monty Brown's going to just wait for it.
Takes a Lors bounce down to about the 30.
You know, if you're a DuHawk offense, you'll take that. You know, at least you're not, you know, 10-yard line, 20-yard line.
That's a worry looking at bounce is it could not bounce in your direction. It could bounce, you know, inside the 10. It would look certain drives right there.
Oh, for sure. How about the Rock Bowl? Let's get it rocking again, huh? Let's see what this offense can do. Evan England again, the QB. He's got Jamel Britt in the backfield.
Owen Libby out there as well.
He's going to hand it off to Jamel Britt. He's going to go out. Good enough for a few yards to about the 32, 33-yard line.
Second and nine now.
Here we go, second down. And there's a flag here. We're going to do a false start, potentially, on the offensive line. They're going to march back.
False start in the offense.
You hate to see it. Yeah. Yep, that'll be on the right guard, Justin Hayes, out of Norwalk, Iowa. We've seen the DuHawks do it before where, you know, they've been assessed a penalty and they make up for it. Can they do it again here? Hopefully no announcer jinx, right?
Hopefully not.
Second down. He's got a receiver down there. It's only a few yards, though. That is Jaheim Haynes.
Yeah, Haynes is second in team receiving yardage coming today. He has a touchdown on the year.
Well, it's third and just a little long. Owen Libby motion to the right. Here's Evan England. He's going to drop back. He's going to see. There's Michael Crawford. He's got more than a first down there.
Across midfield.
Put on your hiking boots. We're marching down the field.
Well, Michael Crawford's first catch of the game. His other one's negated by a penalty.
I'd like to thank Michael Crawford out there. No announcer cheeks on that one.
He's always the worst.
About midfield, here is Evan England. He's going to run out to the right. And it looks like he's just going to run out, just try and get some yardage. Not take the sack, don't take any hits. Pretty smart play.
Oh, yeah. You know, as a QB, you don't want to take any unnecessary hits. Get out of bounds when you can. I said earlier, his legs can make up for broken plays. You saw it right there. Gain about four.
100%. Evan England right now with a QBR of 160.1. Not too bad there.
No, not at all.
13 completions on 18 attempts, 72%. Going to hand it off. And Kaysen bobbling it.
Almost fumbles the ball. Loss of about a yard.
Quick third down. Yeah, Johnny Kaysen so far. He's got a net yardage of minus one. He's staying out there. Let's see if he can make that, you know, 9 yards. Let's see a first down here, huh?
Yeah, third and long. You're probably throwing the ball on this down.
You never know.
Crawford, is he one of your outside receivers?
You never know with this DuHawk offense. Here's England. Offense coming in. Oh, man.
Swallowed up.
Swallowed up there. And fourth down, and the special teams for the DuHawks and for the Dutch will come out. Not what the DuHawks would have liked there, but, you know, You're not going to try and attempt a 60-yard, 70-yard field goal. Looks like there's an injury on the field for the Dutch. So again, 7-7 here. Just over 8 minutes left. You know, let's go through some of the second quarter stats. You know, 3 first downs for the Duhawks, 2 the Central Dutch, 1. 5 rushing attempts for the Duhawks. But again, let's take a look at those rushing yards. This is interesting here. It's tied at 7-7, but rushing yards negative on both sides of the ball. -7 for the Duhawks and -9 for the Central Dutch. What can you attribute that to, David?
Just great front sevens, you know, limiting inside rushes. You haven't seen any guys bounce outside quite yet. And in college, sacks are considered rushing yards. So it's not quite like you see in the NFL where sacks just, you know, are net passing yards.
Again, as you just saw, Kenny kicking that just out to the lower sideline. So pretty decent field position, I'd say, for the Dutch comparative to what they've had so far.
Yeah, both teams have no turnovers quite yet.
That's a nice run there for the Dutch. Again, taking it a few yards.
At number 11, Kyle Norton with the run there.
Rushing attempt by Kyle Norton. Stop made by Milo Collier.
Second and 9 here for the Dutch. Defense looks like they could be blitzing here, and they certainly are, and it is almost...
Ball is tipped at the line.
Almost tipped at the line. Actually, I think it was.
It was tipped. You'd see the ref, you know, making the signal. Another third down here for the Dutch offense.
Pass was deflected by number 95, Preston Petrusik.
Yeah, Preston Petrusik out working wonders here on this defense.
Yeah, the Dutch are 2-for-5 on third down conversions today. While Loris is 1-for-6.
Yeah. Hoffman, 6-for-14 on completions. Not ideal here, but looks like we'll get a timeout.
Central's first timeout of the half. They have 2 left.
I'll try and talk it over again. Third down for the Dutch.
Yeah, Loris is dominating the time of possession today with 8 minutes, 30 seconds, while Central has had the ball for 5 minutes, 42 seconds. That's what you want for Loris today. Controlling the clock.
Yep. 3rd and 9 on the 33 when we return, but you know, looking at this Duhawk defense, what are they doing right on defense? It looks great so far.
Game pressure, forcing quarterbacks to, you know, make decisions, you know, when he shouldn't. You saw that quite a bit. Kind of dirtying the ball. Now, both teams running a lot of shotgun and pistol. I don't think I've seen any under center yet.
3rd and 9 here on the 33-yard line. Hoffman's going to drop back. Looks at a receiver, and it's tipped yet again. Almost caught again.
Another 4th down coming up.
Offense pass was deflected. He's complete.
Duhawks will certainly take that. This crowd likes it.
Yeah, Loris is keeping this high-powered offense and you know, kind of slowing them down.
This is quite the change from what we saw at the Key City Clash, right? Where UD, they were just dominating both sides of the ball.
I mean, early on, it was a low-scoring game. Went 7-3 at halftime. So, you know, you want to see them, you know, do that all game.
Here's the punt here. Monty Brown's going to punt.
Fair caught.
Fair catch at about the 36-yard line. Again, Monty Brown with the touchdown for the Duhawks. That was a great play. We'll see if he can do it around here on this drive. First down for the Duhawks. 1st and 10 on the 36. Jamel Britt in the backfield.
England.
He's going to throw it to Monty Brown. Good enough for a few yards.
Another screen pass.
We're seeing a lot of screen passes here.
Yeah, but both sides. That's it. Third or fourth one from Lors today.
Monty Brown so far, 6 receptions for 88 yards. Here we go on second down.
England right back to him.
There he is, and it's a pick for the Central Dutch.
Double coverage.
And that is the strong safety, Cameron Bannister, taking it back. That is the first pick of the game for Evan England.
The first turnover of the game for either side.
Dutch catching a break there for sure, but great coverage on Monty Brown. He had looked like strong safety there and a corner on him.
Well, evidently it was a safety who made the great play on that ball.
All right, the Central offense has struggled really since their first drive. That first drive, they were marching down pretty decent. We'll see what they can do midfield here. It'll be first and 10 on the 47-yard line.
Hunter Hoffman back out here for, you know, leading the Dutch on their fourth drive of the quarter.
Hoffman's going to hand it off. Pretty decent yards. Going to be swallowed up by that Duhok defense, though.
Gain of one.
Gain of one. Jordan Rush with the ball.
And neither team is dominating the scorebook today.
Okay, if you're looking for a great defensive battle, this is it for you right here. I'm sure there will be adjustments made at halftime, of course. We've got about 6 minutes until then. But, again, defense is doing their part. Here we go. Second and looks like nine. Excuse me, on the 48-yard line. Try and get the play. Rush is in the backfield pretty much next to Hoffman. Hoffman's going to clap. There, he's got the ball. He's going to look to the left. Now to the right. He's going to throw it out. He's got a receiver down, and that's a first down for the Dutch.
Number one, Logan Mont with the reception.
Seen him a couple of times here. Mont out here. It'll be his third reception. And again, here we go with that hurry-up offense. First and 10 on the 39-yard line for the Dutch. Hoffman with the ball. He's going to hand it off yet again.
No, he held on to it.
And he held on to it.
I thought he handed it off well.
Looked that like that was number 22, Dawson Charlie, and number 35, Sean Doyle, eating him up there. Yeah, we've heard Sean Doyle and Dawson Charlie's name here. I think those are two guys who really break out here the rest of this game. Here we go. Looks like second and 15 on the 44. Rush up the right-hand side of Hoffman. You can see three wide to the left. Here's Hoffman. Hoffman's going to look at that left side. He's got a receiver down.
And a nice sell concept that play.
That's the wide receiver, Ryan New. First time we've seen him since the first drive of the game.
Yeah, the Dutch leading receiver so far this year. Through their first five games of the season, has 272 receiving yards.
Third down for the Dutch. You can certainly hear this crowd a little bit.
Yeah, another third down for the Dutch.
Hoffman with the ball. He's going to look to his right. He's got a receiver. Ryan Mott taking him down.
Fourth down.
With Logan Mott, excuse me, and fourth down, not enough for the first down.
Offense staying out on the field.
It's a little
gutsy.
Dutch
are 0 for 1 on fourth down conversions today. Both teams are.
And that's a first down there, and more. And there goes that man. That's Ryan New for the touchdown.
New's seventh touchdown of the season. A massive one. I'm coming on fourth down.
We'll have to take a look at that replay, but it was a great spin move to get off of the tackle.
Yeah, the Dutch take a 13-7 lead.
Yeah, here we go. Hoffman, there's New, and the spin looks like that was Zacchaeus Knight on coverage. Blown tire there, and there's no stopping that here. here we go. Logan Sundvold, the kicker for the PAT, and it is good.
A lot of those good receivers can get yards after catch. Shed a tackle and keep the tire, feet running.
So Dutch here, their second lead of the game since they were up 7-0. So back and forth early on. We'll see if it continues here the rest of this quarter. We've got about 3:45 left. So let's take a look at this offense here. What are you looking for, some type of plays here? We've seen a lot of screen plays, but is that enough for them to march down the field?
You can start wanting to throw the ball more downfield, get Monty Brown more catches, get your tight end Owen Libby, some more catches. Design QB run's been working pretty well. Nothing at the center, really. Hasn't been anything working out so well for either team.
Yeah, and then that was a great drive down for the Dutch.
Yeah, your three receivers have had monster plays so far as well.
Yeah, huge plays for Central's wide receivers. Here we go with the kickoff. Looks like it'll be fair caught at about the, looks like 8 or 9 yard line.
Ball's come out to the 25. It's been a rule implemented in college for the past few years. Now it's made its way to the NFL level, where if you fair catch it inside the 25, the ball is brought back out there, much like a touchback.
And we saw it last time the Duhawks were driving down. The pick for Evan England, you got to wipe that from your memory. You got to have short-term memory on that, and you got to throw it downfield. Here you go. He's going to hand off to Johnny Kaysen. Johnny Kaysen's going to keep going. Little tunnel there. Nice run for him. On defense.
Right guard and center made. Left guard and center made a nice hole for him to get through.
Yeah, we'll take a look at this Dutch defense. Bandy and Backall with half a sack each. They're looking to try and get another one here, but Duhawks having other plans. Monty Brown motion to the right. Going to look
quick
there.
Quick screen.
Very quick screen for Jaheim Haynes. Not much of a gain there.
Third down for the Suarez offense. They are 3 for 9 on third downs today. About 33% of them.
Again, 8 first downs for the Duhawks. They're looking to make that 9 here.
Loris is leading in most categories outside of the scoreboard.
Here we go. We got motions over. England's going to survive that. There he goes. Monty Brown's going to catch that. Now, is that in? Are they going to call that a catch? And they looks like they are.
Yeah, as long as they catch, another catch by Monty Brown.
Move them chains. It's another first down, first and 10 on the 44-yard line.
They win needed. Trust Monty.
Here we go, the handoff to Kaysen from England.
Stop short.
Yeah, a couple of yards on that play.
Just about 2 minutes left in the first half.
It looks like Kaysen's going to go out a little bit towards Crawford. Monty Brown's going to go to the left. Looks like some trickery going on for this offense.
Empty backfield.
So here we go, Kaysen.
In motion.
Michael Crawford in motion. There he is. Or that's Jaheim Haynes. Excuse me. Again, only a few yards on that play. We'll get third down.
Yeah, very even first half so far.
Yeah, definitely back and forth. Here we go on third down for this Duhawk offense. Evan England, nobody in the backfield, and it is caught.
Michael Crawford,
first down. Yes, sir.
Two big catches so far in his quarter.
Fourth first down for the Duhawks for this quarter. Hurry up offense here. England's going to look to his right. He's going to throw.
He's got a receiver there and another first down. Harrison Willis. Out here. Here we go. Another play here for this offense.
Willis with another catch.
And that's Willis again. Excuse me. So stop out of bounds. Second down.
Timeout called.
See, but this is what you want here. You want some momentum. Try and build it up. Say, hey, we're going to get into the end zone. We're going to get at least to the red zone.
Crowd getting into this one right now.
Again, homecoming. You need to have the crowd in this one for sure.
The biggest crowd we've seen here at the Rock Bowl this season.
Without a doubt. Again, the morning tailgate, large amount of people, right? You're seeing that here.
Awesome seeing all these alumni come back.
It's great to see. Great to see here for the students. Let's take a look at some of the game leaders here on both sides of the ball. QB rating, Evan England, 140.3, so staying consistent since our last update of that. Hunter Hoffman went from 99 beginning of this quarter to 141. Again, getting a touchdown there will help improve that. You'll boost that pretty quickly.
Passing yard-wise, Evan England, 152. And counting, you know, the drive. Hunter Hoffman, 123. Coming out of this timeout.
They're back in action. We're back in action. Here we go on second down.
Monty Brown, right side, lone receiver.
There's Jamel Britt brought into the game, and he'll chug along there for a few yards, but it'll be third down.
Third and four.
Again, 42 seconds left on the clock and counting. You want to try and leave with at least a field goal. You want to put some sort of points on right before you get off for half. So here we go. He's going to fake not the bad. Handoff. England, he's got Monty Brown. Monty Brown, touchdown for this Duhawk offense. His second of the game.
I said earlier, get him the ball. He will make you pay.
I know Hugh Maloney and Adam Rodriguez, they love the saying, death, taxes, and Monty Brown. Certainly for this offense, that's the case. Here we go with the replay. Got fake play here to Jamel Britt. Evan England airing it out. Certainly it's the back of the end zone.
Underrated key of that play was the left tackle getting blocking for England.
Here's the PAT by Scott Talmadge. He's 2 for 2 on the day.
Tied of 24 seconds left.
14-14. How about this for a homecoming, homecoming game? 14-14, 24 seconds left.
Monty Brown, 91 yards today.
Sure enough,
Crawford at 23, and Jakeem Haynes with 11.
Yeah, he'll be the leading receiver this game. It'll be 7 receptions. And there's the fight song playing in the background. Take a look at the sideline for Central. Very quiet over there. Back and forth. Let's look at that. Special teams coming out for the Duhawks. Scott Talmadge again will be.
This is a start you want if you're Loris.
Certainly, going into halftime tied, I think that's a win. I think you'll take a look at that, considering a 2-2 record, you'll take that into the halftime.
The Central defense allows 17 points per game. Loris already at 14.
Here's the kick to about the 15-yard line. They're going to try and return it here. Breaking some ankles there. And that's good enough to get up to around the 30-yard line.
If you're Central's offense, what are you scheming up to do this drive with 19 seconds left?
If there are two ways to go about it in my mind. You can try and spike it and just take the time, go to halftime. Or if you're feeling risky, why not try and get a receiver downfield? Try and get as close to field goal range, that you can. It looks like field goals will be the key here, especially in the second half.
Imagine touchdown for touchdown, both teams.
So Hoffman, he's going to just pass it out, and it's going to be certainly just maybe a yard. Maybe they'll just get up to the line of scrimmage.
I think we're heading to half. No.
Yep, so both teams going into halftime. It is 14-14. Again, for the Duhok offense and for this Duhok team, you'll take that.
Absolutely.
You'll take that into halftime. We'll see what they can do on the other side of the half. We'll join you at the other end of the half. Again, 14-14, and we'll see you here in about 20 minutes. Welcome back to Duhok football. Again, it is the homecoming game 2023. My name is Ryan Haywood with David Peters here in the booth. And you're joining us 14. Let's look at some team stats quarters here.
So for Central, 1,300 yards, two touchdowns. One of them to Herbers, who has 6 yards today. And then yards down.
True. I mean, 21-7, 218 yards and 2 touchdowns.
Both of which have gone to Monty, who has 124 yards receiving as well.
Yeah, and of note, yards, Jim, 21 yards. Only in the third and fourth quarter.
Game today. Team.
This is a game that us in the first half. Oh, this is a defense, pure both sides of certainly, but defenses for both teams.
Loris is doing stopping third downs, although have that touch that long fourth down to was that touchdown?
Yeah,
that was a Herbert's touchdown. Great coverage, but
for Central. 61 receiving yards for him, but interestingly enough, he only has 3 receptions thus far in the game. Logan Mont, number 1 for Central, he's got 4.
If you're Loris, what is your game plan for the second half?
You know, there are a number of ways they can take it, but the biggest is got to be making your plays on defense and on offense. Pick for that led to a pretty decent Central. So just, you know, a lot of analysts talk about, oh, you know, the vision's important. It is. It certainly is. If you don't see a receiver, obviously you're not throwing to him, but if you're a receiver, you got to make sure the ball is going straight towards them. Otherwise, it ends up like it did, a pick.
Yep. And being smart when you throw it, too.
Right.
Again, Monty Brown's your best receiver, but don't miss the ball.
Right. So here we go. Kickoff. It is the third quarter, and Talmadge is going to kick it out. The Dutch will take it, and they're going to run it. Good enough, and he's going. He's going. He's got a tunnel. He's got a tunnel over there.
Another return into the 40.
It looks like the ball will be spotted down.
And out comes the Dutch offense for their first drive of the second half.
Yeah, and Hoffman, I mean, he's been pretty decent so far, right? I mean, of course, he's got 2 touchdowns. Of course, he's going to be pretty decent. But we've seen some miscues here and there. You know, some of his doing, some not. But Hoffman, again, doing a great job. He, a QBR rating, 141.7 to Evan England's 162.6. And here we go. Hoffman's going to look. He's got a man deep, and it's almost picked off right
Mike
out
Barber
of the bat.
Almost made the play on the ball.
Yeah, and Barber, we said his name a couple of times, especially in the second quarter.
Yeah, one of those guys that can really change the game on defense.
So second down early. Only like 12 seconds into the game. Got 3 receivers on the right side of the screen towards the top. And here's Hoffman. He's going to clap. Doesn't get anybody there. Nobody's moving. You see that a lot in offenses in the NFL. You try to catch them offside to try more yardage. But it doesn't work here. Here's second down. Hoffman. Hoffman's just going to take it himself, and he'll be taken down about three yards.
About third and 7, another third down for this defense. Third and 6.
Third and 7 for the 44. Let's talk about some of their receivers. Looks like they're going to... This is time out. Put in your defense player. They're going to take a timeout. We're going to continue, but let's talk about reception yards for both teams. Jeff Herber's 61 reception yards so far. I mean, you talked about it earlier. But what's his game like today? Like, how is he getting these yards to continue to attack the deep, the Duhawk defense?
Out physicalizing the Duhawks defense. It's all just bad. He had that one touchdown over here. Yeah, can't point. But he had that one touchdown over the top of the defender's head. Just made a better play on the ball. Ryan New had that fourth down touchdown that just broke free. A bunch of yards after the catch.
Yeah, Ryan New, 38 reception yards. Maybe either one of them get the ball. We'll see here. We'll see what
Central does.
You're
looking for one of them at this point.
Got receiver motions to the left. Now here's Hoffman. Hoffman is going to throw it out there. Again, he's not getting stopped there. Now he is.
Jordan
Way more
Rush
than a first down.
The first down.
Yeah. Get Jordan Rush.
Down conversion. Offense.
We go with this offense again. Rush is going to get the ball again, and he is rushing down. It'll be second down. Pretty decent run.
What kind of halftime adjustments these two teams are going to make? It's been very evenly matched this first half.
Yeah. Certainly a lot will be seen here and next drive, next couple of drives after. But for now, it's second down. Hoffman, he's looking right. He's got a receiver. And caught. Ryan New. He's having him decent day.
Massive game. First down and goal for the Dutch.
Goal for the Dutch.
This might be the game. Third time in the red zone today.
They've got two out of your screen.
That is
Hoffman. And open. Down.
Ryan New gets into the end zone for the Dutch.
Back to back.
Second of the game.
And that's just great QB vision. Amazing, having the awareness, right? To know where your receivers are at all times. Great defense as well by the corners, but
it's a lot of faith and trust in your wide receiver, too, to make that play.
And there for the defense. And good.
21-14. So takes a little.
Very much. In the second quarter, right? When they led Dutch, and then Duhawks marched down. Monty
next
Brown
drive.
Touched. Next drive. Can we see the Duhawks replicate that here?
You would hope so. Yeah, it comes down to Monty Brown once again. We also want to get Michael Crawford, the ball. Owen Libby, I don't think he has a catch yet today.
No, and I said before, he's got to get involved in too, right? Monty Brown pick came about. They had two guys on him, two defensive guys on him, that is. Mixing up here and there, you got to run some nice tight end plays, So we'll see the special teams out here. We'll see how far the Duhawks can run up the field. So again, Logan Sundvold going out for the kick for the Dutch. Just walking, just pacing. Make that he is ready to go.
Fair caught. Drive will start at the Duhawks 25.
So let's take a look at the standings here. The ARC, Wartburg, 3-0, but 5-0. They're a dominant team, right? Duhawks are trying to catch them, but Central is in their way. Central's 2-1 in ARC play, 4-1, followed by Co, 4-1 as well in conference play. We see the hand here from England looked like two. Johnny Kaysen. Wesleyan also 4-1. They're a good team.
Lawrence's opponent next week, too.
Yeah. that here around the fourth quarter, but and then Loris, 2-2. Trying to change that throw from England to Monty Brown. Down, it'll be third down. So we'll see what they do here on third down. The backfield for the Duhawks.
Defense, average 0.3 yards per play today compared to Central's 4.8.
Evans' pass is batted down.
And we'll be out to punt.
That is number 45. And defense, the first time we've heard his name today, but that's a big play.
Yeah, you don't want to start like that for Loris. Don't want to come up flat.
No.
Because we're very quickly could be a two-score game.
So we'll see Kinney here again. Ball going to about the 35-yard line. And it bounds. So we mentioned Warp Juggernaut here. Right now, up north, 35-0 Warburg Knights.
Nebraska and University of Dubuque are tied 21-21 at half. And then Co is up 21-7 against Buena Vista.
Yeah, again, this would be a game for Loris. Try and bring down Central to 4-2, and for Loris themselves to go 3-2. Dutch offense again. Here's Hoffman. The handoff is good enough for quite a few yards. It'll be second and short.
Running ball starting to work this second half. Yeah, Brett Bauer with the tackle. He's a Campbell semifinal.
Very, very big honor that him here and
in the.
Third. There's Michael Barber there on your screen. Made some pretty great plays on defense.
Two very good offenses so far today, being and outshined by great defensive play. Blacks having 222 yards, two touchdowns, and a pick. Hunter Hoff and 173 yards, three touchdowns.
Let's talk about this, Loris, and also we'll talk about the Central defense. And we'll file with four Clark. Three, so those guys step up a little bit now, now that it's third down. Looks like the field. And we'll get back to play now. Third and short. Dutch. Deep here. Snap. Running back motioned right next to Hoffman. Wide receiver motion.
Yeah, one of the third downs today for, you know, in the second half.
And there you go. There's great. Right there, staying in bounds.
That was running back Kyle Norton with the first down reception, the third first down of the for the Dutch.
Yeah, the Dutch had a lot of third downs, especially in the second quarter, that just couldn't take advantage of. Here first, and he can be taken down. No, he's up and this is it for a reception.
Lost.
Looks like number 39 knew as well, but as you mentioned, David, lost it down. Or not lost it down, excuse me, lost the yards.
Still a great play for the quarterback. I'd rather have a loss of two than a loss of seven or eight.
Well, the fact that he got rid of the ball in time without it being intercepted, you know, really, really lucky. They'll take it. Second for the Dutch. Hoffman's going to spin left. He's got a receiver there. And is number five, Jeff Herbers, again with a reception. It's a first for Dutch.
His fourth catch of the day.
Offense. It's what's sun running, especially off of first downs.
Norton with the run on that play gains about two.
So we see here, second down. Looks like there's three wide to the right. Left. Hoffman surveys options, throw quickly to the left.
And Norton gets tackled for the loss of yards. Another third down forced by the Loras defense in this game.
And there's Dawson Charlie's name.
Another screen pass.
Yeah, another one. A lot of screen passes. A lot of screen passes. Third down, we'll see if they can do it again. Wide. Field. It is. That is a great catch by Nick Coble.
He's had some catch of the day.
He's had some bitches here. I mean, second catch, but still two of the bigger catches.
Both off on conversions.
So they're in the zone. It'll be first and goal for the Dutch. It looks like it'll be on the 2 yard line or 4 yard line. Excuse me. And Hoffman, he's looking to Ryan New, and is it
picked off? Mike Barber reception.
There's Mike Barber.
Told you, he's an impact player.
You know, my mom would always say, keep your hands out of the cookie there.
Right, that's
for Mike Barber. And this Loras offense will get a chance to redeem themselves after that first drive.
Now, both guys that are going to make impact plays today have made impact plays. Monty Brown on offense, Mike Barber on defense.
You saw it on that replay right there, too, you know. Being aggressive defense, right? You see the ball, you see a reception, and you're like, hey, if I right? Like the Chicago Bears, Peanut Tillman. That out, you know?
You know, being aggressive, you're going to get penalties called on you, but you're going to make massive plays like that.
Huge call here. First and 10. Fox. JB is going to just run there. He is hard to take down. So we'll see 7-5 on the 25 for the Ducks. Jamel Brick, 6 attempts, 21 yards gained here. Let's see what England can do. Second down.
Escapes pressure.
Slides. They're looking at a flag here.
So he slid, got hit.
I don't know if I would have called for a late hit. The ref.
Yeah. He was moving as he was sliding.
Jamel,
third and four.
To the right. England. England's going to throw. He's got Monty Brown. Monty Brown's going to
be close to that first down marker.
It'll be really. Oh boy, that's gonna be
first down for the Dewhawks.
Well, chains
like I said, you need to capitalize off the move right now.
This looks like a completely different offense from that first drive.
Mm-hmm.
Jamel Britt, a run, and he's taken down just a few yards. So Monty Brown run off. Jaheim Haynes has taken his spot. We'll see second and 10 here for the Dewhawks. Ready. Side for England, and Brown going to go to the right. Here's England. He's going to nice pass,
just
but
outside.
Just outside. Over. That'll be a third down.
Third and 10 for the Duhawks.
It almost looked like that came to surprise for Britt.
That's a nice gain if he can catch that ball.
Britt's averaging 6 yards off carry. And you can hear crowd. There's England and
picked off.
That was intended for Michael Crawford. He couldn't quite get it. And we'll see the special teams come out again. For the Duhawks, that was better. Again, not ideal, not what you see, but have a chance for your defense to try to stop it.
One of the floors.
And it's blocked. Blocked! A blocked kickoff from Kenny. And there. What a. And the Central fans are really, really happy with that, as they should.
He's got right in front of him.
Let's get the replay here. It was just blocked off. It looked like that was number 90. Special team.
Didn't get blocked. And made the kick.
Blocked or tipped. So that changes things here.
Yeah, first and goal for the Dutch.
Unbelievable.
And shifting this half. Didn't see much of that, you know. Either way.
So there's the from Hoffman and a touchdown.
Jet sweep touchdown to Ryan New. He's his third time in the end zone today.
Quite the turn of events. And it is 27-14.
This is not what Loris wanted to start the game.
Here's the replay. You can see New just running in.
That's your point away from a 15 point to the Dutch. Not what Loris wanted to come out this afternoon.
But 2014 with just 6:44 left third.
What a quick turn of events.
Wow.
Crazy how much difference a block punt can make.
Yep, the Rock Bowl is quiet here. The offense really needs to set the tone. This is where you need to start looking at, you know, throwing the ball downfield. You got to find your game changers and your guy, Monty Brown.
Yeah. Ryan now has three touchdowns today, two in the air, one on the ground.
And you talked about it earlier, you know, capitalizing on these mistakes, whether they're picks, whether they're, you know, just defensive stops. And you said it. Whoever
wins the turnover battle.
Yep.
You need to score up those turnovers as well. We saw that right there. Loris couldn't capitalize off that interception. Central comes back, blocks the kick, scores the touchdown.
So we'll sinful yet again on a kickoff. There he goes.
Put a lot of pressure on the Loris punter all game, though. Got hit earlier.
A couple of bounces, you know, inbounds, and then, you know, that's just, sometimes that's the way it rolls. Figuratively and literally.
Yeah. All right. Evan England leads the Loris offense back out on the field after a critical mishap.
And a lot, especially down the road. I mean, obviously, you can't really say now, but, you know, if Central does go to 5-1, it's going to make it really tough for the Duhawks to try and come back.
Yeah, between them and Wartburg for the title, too.
Yeah, I mean, there's still a ton of teams still in it. You know, Wartburg, Co., Central.
Oh,
as that was almost picked off.
Versus not pink right now.
No. It's just running string of bad luck. See what they can do here. Again, that was Jaheim Haynes, excuse me.
So it looked like he bobbled it. 2 weeks ago, close game at half, and then stakes start piling up early on in the second.
And that's exactly it. We'll see a second and 10 on the 25 here. Johnny Kaysen. Kaysen's going to get a pretty decent run here and is taken down. Number five, that is a corner, Ben DeMilurney.
Third down.
DeLurney really, really hyped up after that. Kaysen Field. Third and on the third line. Kaysen motions left. England is going to try. And it's. Again. Gavin Smith. 21 on almost with the ball. And it'll be yet again another turnover.
Smith has been all over this second half, making massive plays. Dutch defense.
Yeah, again. Dutch defense.
Overloading the line.
Low.
Almost blocked.
And looks like it'll be fair caught at around the 26-yard line. Dutch defense. Unbelievable. No one can see if I'm that on the Duhawks right now.
Yeah, Laura's 1-for-4 on third versions this quarter.
You need to find here on defense. Just bring a stop here and then have a chance to field with your offense, right? That's the name. You're down fours. It's a little and a half.
That make big time third. Plays.
These are where your guys like Dawson Charlie and Ben Doyle, you know, this is where Sean Doyle, excuse me, this is where they, you know, come out and make some big plays. As that run about almost to the first down marker. And short for the Dutch.
Run game is very really opening up. Gonna have back right back to first down,
and that's Rush with another rush, and it's good enough for a first down.
They're rotating Rush and Norton out quite a bit so far.
Definitely split backfield, but he's gonna throw it. Hoffman's gonna throw it. Makes a defender touch grass.
Loss of three.
That is Mont right there.
Following the defense, we're going to do quite a bit. They can start to get hired, and
they can see a lot of
things. Yep.
This is really off important. The field. Really important. Just clown. Just remember in practice, situation, they're your dog tired, 90-degree weather, right?
Most important time of the game.
See what this defense is made of here on second down. Almost midfield for the Dutch. Hoffman fakes a handoff. He's going to throw it. He's got a receiver just to the side. They won't play. It's third down.
That's quite a few times he's overthrown his.
But again, you can make those just as long as you're capitalizing on bigger ones, you know? I mean, it's different on a, you know,
wide open
third down for a touchdown for a fourth down, right?
And first down.
Duhawks stopping on Rodgers, trying to get in the heads of Hoffman. Hoffman's going to throw. Doesn't get it off, and he is taken down.
Third time today, Hunter Hoffman goes down. Another punt forced by the Duhawk defense.
And that is big. Again, we said it before the drive. This is where you know where you're made, what you're made of, right? You got to just do a little digging. Try and just grit it out, and sure enough, stop them on third down, and now it's punt time for the special teams.
Said, I hope your offense comes out, scores, makes it closer.
Here we go with the punt from Burn.
Brown, get to
take a central Dutch bounce, but goes out. Duhawks, offense back.
Four.
So, what adjustments do you think should be making? Now, obviously, you've got to be making your plays. You got to be hitting your receiver. Other than that, what do we need to see?
Again, capitalize. You're down 14. Get the ball to your playmakers. His name quite a bit today, Monty Brown. He is your best player on this offense. Ball, work.
As the kids say these days, let him cook. So, we should have an England cook. He was
Anthony Brown.
Crawford.
And there's Crawford.
Yeah. Gain of 5 or 6.
Give or take, yeah. And again, varying the receivers that you go to, so it's not always Monty Brown, because you know, Monty Brown doesn't always work.
He wanted him, double.
Three guys bunched up, three receivers bunched up to the right of your screen. England's going to look. Gervais avoids the sack, but he's scrambling. Offensive line not holding up too much.
You know, F, they're protecting Evan pretty well. Not so much. Not even. We saw Hunter Hoffman go.
Most of the line being subbed out. This is interesting. Dutch are doing. Reed Packabear. Linebacker for the Dutch on the right side. He's lining up. Looks like it could blitz.
Yeah, Packabear is the Dutch leading tackler today.
Hands of James, and that is number 5, Ben DeMillery, touchdown for the Dutch. That is the second pick on the day for Evan England.
And Dutch, 20. Not the half.
So the score for now, 14. Just under 3 minutes left in the third, and it's a big nightmare on homecoming for the duo.
Well, the same thing happened last week, or 2 weeks ago against Dubuque. Start piling, you get behind the scoreboard, and you got to start climbing back.
Holds PA's good, and that'll make it 35-14. Again, here's replay of that pick, but Jaheim Haynes, you saw that right there. He had it. It's just somehow bounced out. It looked like, you know, as we're looking at the return, it looked like Haynes, like, hit his forearm almost.
Just bounced up. And
just bounced out. You know, sometimes just luck goes your other way, you know.
Good play by the cornerback. Getting the ball and getting in the end zone.
It'll definitely quiet down this Loris crowd on homecoming. Definitely a big spoil for the Dutch, right? You know, you come in competing for ARC title. It's middle of the season, towards the end of the season, and Loris coming on the road. They've done everything now in this third quarter to try and flip the script, because it was really close in that first half.
Yeah, when halftime 14-14. Now the Dutch scored 20.
So we'll see another kickoff here from Sunvold. Take very deep. It's going to be returned. Decent amount. It's about the 25-yard line.
Duhawk offense comes right back out after the pick six.
Yeah, they be tired.
It's one of those times where you can't let that play affect you. You just got to come back out, do the
exactly.
Same players, juiced up. That's the worst thing you can do is let, you know, other plays affect you. Just focus on the next. You can't change whatever you happened.
England's QBR rating going down to 128. Looks like it would be a false start on the offensive line.
Second one of the game. So.
False start. Offense over to 72.
Tyler Harper. No, sorry, wrong team.
Yeah, that's going to be
Caden Carnes.
Caden Carnes.
With a false start.
Starting right tackle out of South Beloit, Illinois.
Duhawks back 5 yards.
Jamel Brick carry here. Obviously, getting close to the line of scrimmage, but.
You know, second down and 10.
Yeah. No, they'll make it right there. Second and 11. You got to think a throw play's got to be in the cards here for the offense.
You can still run second, but if it's third and long, you got to throw it.
See what they do here. England Michael sees Crawford.
Third down once again.
That was the cornerback, Gavin Smith, on Crawford. Again, he's been doing pretty good, too, on coverages. You know, covering your guys, trying to make sure you got your hands up, trying to get down, doing his job. Can't ask for much more than that here from the defense.
Wars in for 17 on third down conversions today.
The throw over, and it's almost picked off yet again by Central College. That looks like that Winston Burns.
I think so.
Yeah, linebacker out of William. And that would have been the third pick for Evan England.
Just on here, it's the left third quarter.
And the punt
goes
can of corner aft and goes
midfield to take over.
Great field positioning. Again, they could put them up.
Points.
Yeah.
You start nearing, you know, when's cut off of being able to come back from this deficit?
I believe in miracles.
So, saying that, you know, again, you got to start getting a little nervous.
They got to start creating luck defense. You've got to put yourself out there trying to take some more.
They're still playing well.
They're playing well. But trying
kind
to
of hurt them. No. First going goal. Stop six. Four. Only scored seven against the Duhok defense on an actual drive today. Or this half.
Hoffman in the Dutch.
Herbers goes into motion, hands off to.
Good enough yards. So we'll see second and five on the 42-yard line. Just like that, you know. Making small plays like that, pretty big, turn out to be pretty big plays in the end. But here's Hoffman. He's got a receiver there, and there he goes.
A lot of rollouts for Hunter Hoffman.
Yeah, again, Hoffman doing a great job this second half. Finding receivers. And again, this hurry-up offense. We keep saying it over and over, but it's exactly what it is. As we see here, it'll be a second. That was Kyle Norton again. Just under a minute left in this quarter.
Starting to get their tight end, you know, into the game plan in the second half. As Cole will not, you know, catches in the third quarter.
Looks like they're ready. Hoffman with the ball. He's going to air it out.
Herbert.
He's got almost caught.
Outside.
Most caught.
Receiver's hands.
That was Jeff Herbers.
Said his name quite a few times today, too.
Oh, yeah. Again, just we've seen from Hoffman. Again, as I mentioned earlier, you can make those mistakes as long as you make a better play. And that's what's doing right now. Looks like some substitutions on the field coming in. 23, that's the tight end, Grant Nelson. And Mott's going to motion over to the right. Hoffman's going to look. And it'll be
down.
Again, good catch. Does the running back, Kyle Moulton.
Dutch offense staying back out for fourth down.
And why not? Why wouldn't you? You're up by
one
points.
For two on fourth down. Last one. Timeout called.
Crowd was getting into it for the Duhawks, but we'll transition the third quarter to the fourth. 15 minutes left. And there's a you can see on lots of them here today. Maybe we're on hand to see a little bit of a comeback. At the very be competitive,
mm-hmm.
Right? You don't want to go out and on a bad note, you know.
Make the game seem close. You don't want to get blown out in homecoming.
And there's the sideline. Dutch pretty much just take
it. What kind of play you're drawing up for fourth and five?
You know, five is interesting. You know, you could go for a traditional run. You could go for a traditional play action. Draw off some of those defensive ends, defensive linemen. And again, hey, Ryan New. Find her. Find whoever's in. They've all been thrown. I mean, averaging. But Mott's got 3.2 yards. But
he has 5 today. The long of 13.
I expect this defense, you know, you've had about, you know, a minute. Try and talk it over with coach and the staff. Try and to play here on fourth. I mean, the Dutch have other plans. Hoffman's looking, and it is just
incomplete.
Yeah, incomplete.
Off target.
It looked like it was in the middle of three different receivers. But that's good news for the Duhawks. They'll take over there. And potentially,
you know, offense time to rest.
Yeah.
Hopefully come back out.
Potential rest for the defense. You hope so. Offense got to stay up.
Now
Jim Haynes, Johnny Brown, and Michael Crawford out.
Empty backfield.
Kaysen lined up right behind Crawford. So here's England. England's going to move over to his right. He's going to find Monty Brown. It's good enough for a first down, but can they get more out of it? And they certainly do. Move the chains for Monty Brown.
Got to keep feeding the ball. He's defense pay. You know, he's lined up with the slot receiver right now.
In the back. Handoff. For about what, 4 yards?
Yeah. Or five.
Mark him. But this is what you want to see, you know, just keep making the next best play. Right? And we'll see a second and six on the 43.
Empty look.
Yep.
Tight end line of the wing.
Monty's being motioned to the left.
And doubles.
England, look, he's going to take a shot over. And brings it in. And as you said, a nice catch for Jaheim Haynes.
Another first down for the Duhawks. High at first, but they bring,
you know,
it in.
A little high, but as long as you bring it in, right? Another first down. Engel's going to find Monty Brown. Monty Brown, nice juke move over, and he'll get taken down over by the third. Money, 35-yard line.
Yeah, Miles, 12 receptions. Over 100 yards and 2 touchdowns.
You know, we're seeing the clock move down. You talked about it, clock management being a key in the second half as Michael Crawford gets the reception there from England. You know, we're seeing the clock. It's 13, 17, 16, 15. It just keeps moving. What do you do as coach to try and encourage the clock to stop? Like, what can you try and do?
Start throwing the ball towards the end, towards the, you know, out of bounds and really know, you know, what you've really been able to do for them this quarter.
There's Kaysen with the run, and it looks like we'll see where they mark him. It didn't look like he crossed the marker. He only gets 1 yard, but fourth and one on the 31. Looks like the offense is going to stay out there. Why not?
It's one of those plays where you go under center, have a QB sneak.
You would think.
Not a big fan of shotgun. Short.
ML Britt, the running back, going towards the left of your screen.
And Jaheim.
This thing is Britt a little bit. Here comes, and he is. But Monty Brown with the catch.
First down. Go.
And there. Guy down. Really gutsy play call there.
That left really the edge rusher unblocked.
So they'll take a timeout down there. Have a meeting on the minds of both sides of the ball. We've stopped 0-3. It'll be a first one they resume for the Duhawks.
One thing that's interesting now, in first downs, the clock does not stop anymore.
Right.
You know, previous years in college football, stop, you know, allows to make more plays. He's running until 1 minute left in the quarter.
Monty Brown, 13 receptions for yards
and 2 touchdowns.
He's having himself a day. Michael, next lead, 2 Hawks, options for 44 yards.
Doing a good job of spreading the ball around, though.
Yep. It's all you can right now, 35-14. We'll see here down what they'll do. Going low, hands it off to Britt, and Britt
barrels down.
Again, very tough to take down, but he stopped there. Multiple guys at the line. It'll be 2nd and 6 on the 24-yard line. Duhawks not on more of the red zone.
Add it to 24.
Getting really close. This crowd's itching.
This should be a massive touchdown. To score.
England on 2nd down. He finds Owen Libby, and that is his first play. Got to get your tight ends involved, right?
Yeah, oh yeah.
Be another stoppage of play. You know, let's preview next week's match. Lincoln, Nebraska, Duhawks on the road against Nebraska University. 1 o'clock start time. And so far, you know, University of Dubuque 32-21 in the third over Wesleyan. So, what can we expect from that game, David?
A defensive battle once again. Same thing happened, you know, with UD last week, you know, 2 weeks ago. Game is close at halftime, and the second saw the same thing today for Nebraska Wesleyan. You're hoping, you know, a good close game. Defensive back teams will have, yeah, solid defenses, good offenses. Close.
Yes. University of Duke looking to 2 and 3. If they hold on in the third and the fourth quarter, Nebraska Wesleyan could be taken down to 4-2. We'll update you on that score as we progress here. But for now, it's a 35-14 game for the
short.
For a
jump.
Looked like there's a flag on the play. Free play, and it's inbound. It looks like on the
Dutch. You know, free for the off, whatever happens, getting a first down regardless.
Looked like the D lineman jumped.
Mm-hmm. Sideline.
Plays. Well, Tyreek C in the NFL. No other great plays in days, right? The toe drags, all the fancy stuff. Britt's going to run in off the handoff from England and just inching closer.
That's 2nd and goal now.
Looks like Mike Brown to the right, along with Michael Crawford. Jamel in the backfield. We'll see what kind of run play they'll do here. Or a throw. Looks like a throw. England is sacked. He is taken down yet again. That is Bradley Warren. Number one.
Finally had a hard time protecting him in the second half. That's his 3rd sack of the game.
Offensive line looking really tired out there and trying to hold your guy. All of a sudden, a few turns, a few quick arm moves, and you're on the ground, right?
If the Dutch rotating their D line quite a bit, it makes it a lot harder for the offensive line.
They'll take their time with this. They've got 14 seconds on the play clock. England 3rd and 7 on the 7.
Number 5 now.
He's going to Jaheim, and he catches it, but it is out of bounds.
And the Duhawks are staring at four. Looks like the offense is staying there, but could you make an argument to have Scotty come out and kick a field goal?
No. Under 10 minutes left, you got to get a touchdown. It's
and agreed. Got plenty of time on the play clock now.
Three receivers set. DeMonte Brown is at the top of your screen.
Here's the snap. And in trouble, and he is down.
Sack.
Fourth time. Looked like that's Bradley Warren. Two. The same drive on Evan England.
Almost back-to-back plays, too.
The Duhawks could just not get it done there. Knocking on the red zone. In the end zone, excuse me. They cough it up to the Dutch, and the Dutch will have a first 10 on their 11.
A lot of ground to cover for the Dutch in this drive.
Works in favor of Duhawks. There's a nice there.
Jordan gets the first down. Dutch.
Stopping all defense throughout the game. Hoffman, another handoff. The defensive line will come there. And he'll be stopped. For a third down, but Rush doing his part today. Yeah. 21 yards.
It's 9 carries, 8 yards.
8 yards, one on receptions, and off trouble, and he's just going to stop right there.
It's one of those situations where you need to throw the ball away.
That was a nice sack. Miley-air had a couple of nice plays, too, on the day. So third down here for Dutch. 8.5 left to go. Substitution. Looks like that's the tight end. Preston Rowe coming in for Logan Mott. They've swapped out a couple times throughout the game. Could see like a tight end throw pass. We'll see what they do here. Hoffman looking at his options. A throw towards the line, and it's broken up.
Wide receiver new. Punt forced by defense.
Yeah, Brandon Felt. Head linebacker on that. Okay, nice hit there. And let's end out Duhawk offense yet again after the punt.
Monty Brown back deep to receive.
Almost blocked. Monty Brown will fair catch it at the 30-yard line.
Great for the Duhawks.
40-yard line. Sun's starting to come out a little bit. A little brighter on. Beautiful day for football.
It's a beautiful day for football.
Oh.
Receiver set at top of your shotgun.
He's gonna get the ball. He throws Johnny Brown. Brown's gonna get a out of this, but a nice tackle from Reed Packabier, linebacker.
He's the Dutch leading tackler. Gain of nothing on Monty Brown.
Looks like there's a flag. Hey.
False defense.
Again, a key takeaway for this team. Both sides, I mean, it's just, you know, not trying to draw flags, not trying to draw any penalties because you're losing that you could making up plays where you're not making all these, right?
setting you back up for a hard time trying to pass the ball. Have you? But you know, we'll see here. Evan England, second down. Yeah.
You know, that penalty goes from 2nd and 10 to 2nd and 15. It changes.
Getting great tackle. That is number 59, Colby Svetska, on the defensive line.
Just over. 6 minutes left.
Looking for, can they get something here? England's going to find Michael Crawford. Crawford's going to step out of bounds, and it'll be a fourth down.
You have to keep this on the getting the ball back.
You never, we've seen it before, right? Converting on fourth down.
Absolutely.
A little bit of a stretch here, but you're staring at the clock and being realistic. Try and get a little closer. Inch a little bit closer.
Fourth and 8. Find your playmaker.
There's Evan England. He's going to try and look. He's in trouble. He's going to launch it, and it goes out of bounds. And the Dutch will take over.
On the side.
6.5 minutes left in the fourth quarter. Defense is ready to go out. You know, we're Dutch right here, and is there a player sticking out to you today that you're saying, hey, with 6.5 minutes left, they're the play?
For Dutch offense?
Yes, sir.
It's between Herbers and New. Those two guys have just made plays. You know, New has 3 touches, one on the ground, 2 in the air. And just...
very dominant. Nice run.
Stays going.
It's number 12. Keith Glover, quarterback.
What'd you call an angry run?
It looks like the
2 quarterbacks.
Yeah, Hoffman out wide.
Yeah. Saw that.
And Glover is going to be down around the line of scrimmage. You know, trick play. Why not?
Yeah.
Try to get something going.
I saw both quarterbacks. I was like, oh, it's kind of interesting, but.
Their goal is to try and chew some clock up, make sure this game, run down the clock, get the game over with.
Yeah, don't let any, you know, don't make any mistakes.
So here we go, second down. Out.
Yeah, you know, caught in the backfield. Nope. Third and 5. Keep him backs out there.
About 18 seconds left on the clock. Time. See what they can do here. Looks like Hoffman's going to take. He's going to hand off yet again. Glover is going to get really close. I think he's short. At least by a few inches from the first down marker. Yeah.
Glover already has 23 yards on the ground.
He's going to be short. It's short. And looks like 4th and 1. 4th and inches.
Yeah, Glover now the leading the game.
They're gonna go try and squeeze some points out. Logan Stubble, his kick is good.
4 possession game now for the Dutch. Point.
Yep, 38-14 here as we draw to the conclusion of the game. Our next telecast will be 2 weeks from this Saturday, as Loris goes on the road next week. Nebraska. But Saturday, October 21st, our next broadcast will be against Wartburg coming into town to the Rock Bowl.
For Wartburg.
Number four Wartburg. You know, tough test. We'll see what the Duhawks are made of there.
We'll be the best team we face all year.
Yeah, at that point, likely so. Again, the making a run for Wartburg money here in the ARC. Let's take a look back at the Buena Vista game. 57 bumping in the fourth quarter here.
Running away with it.
Yeah. I mean, you look at that score, they'll go to 5-1. Excuse me, Buena Vista will go 0-5. Buena Vista searching for some answers. But we'll look at Nebraska Wesleyan. They're down 21-49 in the University of Duke. About 14 left in the fourth quarter there.
Duke looking for their second win of the season.
Yeah, their first win came. Key City Clash. Duke against, excuse me, Loras College in Duke.
That was the first field goal we've seen all game. It wasn't after a touch. It wasn't a PAT.
Yeah. I think missed opportunities here. I mean, you could have sent Scotty Talmadge out. You know, that one play where it's one and go for the end zone, right? A fourth and goal, excuse me. Try and get some points out. But again, your debt situation, you know, and try and go for it at that point. So here's Kaysen's going to get off of that. Good enough for at least 2 yards.
Yeah, broke a nice tackle on that play.
Second down from the 27.
Yeah, today, Kaysen, he's had 10 attempts, 20 yards gained. Ain't going to find someone. He'll find Monty Brown. Brown will go back and juke. Two different defenders being taken down.
Yeah, third and five.
That was a nice play on defense.
15 catches for Damani Brown.
Yep. There's Jaheim Haynes. He's taken down as well.
Moves the chains.
Jaheim Haynes. I would say.
Just catches 50 yards.
A stop here. Potentially a timeout from Dutch. Saw their coach go out. Not quite sure what's going on right now.
No, penalty.
Clock was off. We'll find out here. And a delay of game is called against the Loras offense.
Delay game warning.
Warning, excuse me.
Not entirely sure what that means, but
well, at least it's a warning, right?
Yeah.
You don't take an off, right?
Especially this late in the game.
Yeah. England's going to throw. And Shaheen's at midfield. He's taken down at around the 40-yard line.
Two pitches for him.
Yep. On hurry up, England's gonna try and find Crawford. He gets him, it comes out, and Croft's been out. Another looked like they even got the down.
No,
blinking, you'll miss it. Offense right here,
man. England, yeah, oh.
Chain guys, what are we doing? As England is taken down again, now the chain guys
five,
are down.
He's been sacked five times today.
That offense, and you know, neck guy. Better from the offense. Fine. You know.
Over 300 yards today. Yep. Two touchdowns, two interceptions. And a QBR 6.8.
Here he is on the throw. He's going to find again. Another first down, but we got a back where England fell.
Roughing the passer, actually. Know where the flag's at in backfield.
Flag looks like it's at the 3.
You know, right around.
Excuse me. Good call there, David. So automatic first down. Here we are.
familiar situation. The Duhawks knocking on the red zone door. Can they open it?
Hopefully.
We'll see here. Hope. Why not? You got 2:23 left. And
so that.
And some killers going here. Special time. Try and stop the play.
First on the sick for the Duhawks.
You know, make it as
you've got right you back pretending.
Really, are they going to smack? No. I think so, but if you can get a touchdown here, now that, you know, lighter note, right?
Mm-hmm.
As you head to Nebraska Wesleyan.
Makes you feel better if you get a touchdown.
Yeah. I will say, fans traveled pretty decent, filling up the stands over by Roman Hall.
Most in all year.
Oh, yeah. Well, they recognize it, big game, our home, you know.
Close game went.
So the field getting a little bit of mate here. What do you think? Water? Gatorade?
I'm not entirely sure. Not sure what they're doing over there.
Patching up some holes, perhaps. There were some puddles, potentially, and just add a little more water. Why not? Why not? The offensive line.
All right, we're back. Game.
A little hiatus there, but not too terribly long, and we'll see. First goal on the 6-yard line. England is going to pass it out to Jamel Britt. That sniffed out, but tackle can't twice. Nice move by. He's had a pretty decent day, you know, yards wise and just making some nifty moves.
37 yards on the ground, no, 7 on in the air. Not a bad day.
See 3 wide, 1 to the right. Here's England. England's going to look to his left. Yeah, he's why not? Just. He was looking at Monty Brown, but.
Jaheim Haynes again. Across. Again. 8 catches today.
Last drive for the Duhawks today on offense. 7 on the 7-yard line. He's got eyes on someone, but he does.
Worst down, 6 sack, you know, that Dutch
is,
defense.
That is Bradley Warren. I believe his 3rd sack one today. At least of this half, this is his 3rd sack. We'll see a timeout.
Game.
Sack.
A 6 sack for the Dutch.
Yep.
And Loris calls a timeout.
Keep in mind, this is their first timeout of the half.
And he's 1-5.
Yeah. Well, you know, do you think, you know, for the coaching staff, do you think working in these timeouts could be a little bit more beneficial? Pause. On in the game.
It's a big play. Just come down. Defense. Offensive. You know, calm down. You know, 90 seconds left. You know, down by 24. Shit you can do. Have you seen crazier things happen?
We have seen crazier, you know. We certainly have.
Well, it takes a few onside kicks. You're back. No easy task, though.
No, not with a 1:30.
No.
Back after the timeout.
Fourth goal, it's just kind of what play do you think into the end zone? And it looks like he could be sacked yet again, and that's how the offense is going to do it, and that's how the game's going to end.
Seven sacks against Duhawk. You know, the game that started at the halftime, you know, very good. Came out in the second half kind of flat, and it stood up. Oh, it's a blocked punt.
So defense up there. Offense, I imagine it's just going to be ball and
yeah, just kneel out. Get a first down if, you know, Boris calls an out.
I mean,
don't.
It'll be a run here. And we got some extracurriculars in the back, 38 and 7. I'm a little shocked they didn't flag out there.
Oh, they did call a timeout, though.
Yeah. Well, I guess this late in the game, right? What are you going to do?
Yeah. You know, let's talk about some positive things. DeMond, 15 catches, 159-yard touchdowns. Jaheim Haynes, 8 catches, 92 yards. And then Michael Crawford, 8 catches, 92 yards. You know, you're the monster receiver for Loris.
Yeah, I can... James has to. Has to, right? He's the 2 touchdown. I've seen some guys like from Jaheim Haynes from and Kaysen, but we'll see how they can rebound in Lincoln next week against Nebraska Wesleyan.
And defensively, Hayful is your leading tackler. He has a TFL today.
This run play is sniffed out by Loris.
Well, we should see Loris, you know, Loris should get the ball once again.
I'm out.
At 13. First down. Do ball. Kim's. Between there. Kind of surprised him to call the timeouts, though.
Just held on to him. But again, coaches, they've got their reasons why. They're the guys down there making decisions, right? Mm-hmm. There's a reason for everything. Every play, every decision. So here we go, back again, third down. Got motion play here. And the defense, almost a sack out, and it'll be out of. So that'll stop. So it looks like the Dutch, they're going for it.
Guess so.
And why would, I mean, I guess why not? Catch him.
Remain.
Keegan Glover, 12 out there, in addition to out there. They've been running dual quarterback plays pretty decently.
They've gone up as running back.
And nice run there by Keegan Glover. That should pretty much do it. Play clock at 36. Clock at 5. And that's going to wind down things. Homecoming. 23 for the Duhawks. Again, the score, 38-14. David, what are some of your takeaways?
You know, it was a great first half. You know, went into halftime 14-14, and mistakes started piling up in the second. Like I said, you got to capitalize off turnovers. So did that. Protect your kid. 7 sacks. Hard to win a game. Penalties.
Yeah. So we'll see what the Loris Duhawks will do against Nebraska Wesleyan next week at Lincoln. Our score here, 30-14, Central. David, thanks for being today, and everybody at home, thank you for tuning in today. My name is Ryan. Sign up, and we'll see you when we see you.